What's up, guys? So Uncut Gems is the new kind of crime drama. Not really crime, but it's the new fast-paced drama starring Adam Sandler. He plays a character who is working as a manager of this diamond shop, this business tour. He's in that sort of area of working, and he gets this rock diamond for not a lot of money, but he wants to make a lot of money off of it, and he cons people to give him things to where he says he's going to give certain things back because he owes some people money in the meantime. So basically this is a movie of him hustling to survive and make a lot of people a lot of deals that hopefully are going to come through. He has a gambling addiction, which I thought was so interesting to see in this movie, because we don't really see a lot of movies with people with gambling addictions. See a lot of movies with alcohol addictions, drug addictions, but gambling addictions, I don't see that a lot in films. So that was really, really cool to see that in this movie. And I think Adam Sandler does a great job in this. He carries this movie from beginning to end. His acting in this is really good. He's not giving like an Oscar-winning performance, I don't think, but he's really solid in the movie. Everybody else is good as well. Idina Menzel has a side role. I thought she was great. I thought all the mob kind of guys he was dealing with were great. His mistress, Adam Sandler's mistress in the movie, not sure the actress's name, but she was really good in every scene she had. And I thought this movie was extremely well-paced. I mean, right when this movie starts, you're in the thick of it with Adam Sandler and what he's going through in life, and you understand what this guy's doing, and it's the plot and the story kind of continues. You get more into what actually is happening, what he's doing, the deals he's making with people. And I thought it was really riveting, you know? I thought it was very riveting. And the only thing I don't like about this movie is the ending. Without spoiling it, I don't think the end of the film worked for me. It was kind of, it didn't leave a sour taste in my mouth, but it left a taste of, I can't say, really. I really can't say, because it probably will go into spoiler territory, so if you plan on seeing this movie, I can't tell you, but I didn't really care for the ending of this movie. But the rest of it, I thought it was great. I thought it was riveting. I thought the pacing was good. This movie has some dark humor in there. There's scenes that are intense. This is just a great film to watch. I loved it. I did. I really loved it. And I'm going to give this movie a very, 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 very solid 4 out of 5 stars. I was thinking about 4.5, but is that a little slightly too high? It might be if I see this movie again. Maybe I'll give it a 4.5, but it's close. It's tipping the scale, because this is a very strong 4 for me. 4 out of 5, very, very strong 4. So guys, comment your thoughts in the comments. Do you plan on seeing Uncut Gems? Did you see it already? What are your thoughts about it? And also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I will be seeing Little Women pretty much right after I'm done recording this, so I'm going to go off to see that. Then it's time for Christmas dinner. Happy Christmas to you all. Hopefully you all have a happy and safe holiday. I hope you guys have a great day. And yeah, you could also follow me on Facebook and Twitter. The links to those are in the description of this video. And you could also follow me on Instagram at KingArises131. And that's about it, guys. And also, don't forget, there's top 10 best movies of 2019 and top 10 worst movies of 2019. Those lists are coming next week before New Year's Day, obviously, as I've been doing it for the last 7 years. So, yeah, that's about it, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, over and out.
KJ, it's game night. You should be stretching out.
What is he, a coach?
Nah, he's just a fucking crazy ass Jew.